Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today is a very, very beautiful day. Sun is out, it's nice and warm. It's about 15 degrees and I just love it. It feels like spring, but it's only February. And I've been away from YouTube for a while because I was selling my house and buying another house. And I was busy with work, and well, in fact, it was a bit too much for me, and so I have to set some priorities. And oh no, Bert, oh my god, why is he always Wilbert? Don't. Oh, my bloody cat is always walking between my plants and bumping things over. Okay, so where was I? Yeah, I was busy with work and house stuff, and I just have to set some priorities. Hey, Bert. Oh. And yeah, so I bought a house, and my house has been sold last week, and I'm very happy because it was doing well on the market, let's say. And yeah, I will be moving somewhere in May, and yeah, that means my mind is settling down. I'm still busy with work, but I'm trying to deal with that. So, well, enough, let's get you into my orchids. So, over here I have my 2 out of 3 Lelia anceps. This is a variety semi-alba, and this is just the normal one. They are potted in LECA, and the reason why they are in LECA and not semi-hydro is because I want to place them outside when the night temperatures are a bit warmer, because now it is about 2 degrees and maybe next week it's about 5 degrees Celsius at night, so they can handle that. So they're easier to handle in LECA when they are outside. And over here are my Vendas. As you saw in my last video, I kept them in the closet because people were coming over and looking at my house. And what I did was I had 2 days with people in my house, and on the other days I just placed them back in my windowsill, and they are doing very, very nice. I don't see any new root growth, but they look happy and healthy. Yeah, that's Wilbert. Hi Wilbert, behave please. Hello, sorry for the shakiness. I'll get you in by hand. So in here I have just a bunch of plants. I have a Cattleya gold digger, something, something, I don't know. This is just a houseplant, or outdoors. Depends on where you live. This is Alocasia macrorhiza. This one is in soil and this one is in semi-hydro, because I want to do a little experiment to see what works better. And over here is my Lelia anceps for cerulea, and that is also placed in lava rocks and some gravel stones. And it has, I'm not sure if I can get it out, let me try. I have to pause you for that. So this is my Lelia, I'll place it here. I think that is easier. And as you can see, it created quite a nice spike over here. And it ended with this leaf right here. And if I look down in here, I don't see anything yet. But I'm not sure what the growth habit is on this particular plant. But yeah, it's doing good. It's growing, so I just have to Wait and see. And over here, this is my big blue-purple Venda. It is doing very, very well. It created some, I don't know if you can see it, but like down there, it created a keiki. It already had two other keikis, but they're just still very, very small. So, but yeah, it's doing okay. And over here, a very beautiful IKEA phalaenopsis. I absolutely love the color. It's a bit yellow, mauve, pale, but I really, really love it. And over there, whoops, is my Cattleya Glauca. And that is getting a lot of sun over there, so it's really happy. Over here, let me check. I have three other Cattleyas doing great. And over here next to my window are a few Phalaenopsis taking a really nice sun bath. And this one is a no ID. It's a bit pale yellow with a gorgeous purple center and a deep red lip. So it's very cute and it's growing really, really well. Then over here in the back, I have a no ID white Phalaenopsis, and that is still in bark because I tried to self-pollinate it and I think it went all right. So I did this on the 1st of January, and yeah, so the seed pods have to stay on for a little while, I guess until May or June. And that is also the reason why I just let it stay in bark, because I really don't want to disturb this Phalaenopsis. And this is the flower. I think it's quite special. It reminds me of the species Phalaenopsis, so it could be a cross, but I'm not sure. I think it's the shape and the coloring and the patterning. But yeah, it's still a no ID, but I absolutely love it. And I tried to pollinate it just by experiment, because I didn't have at the time a lot of other Phalaenopsis in bloom, so yeah, why not try it out with a no ID. And oops, I'm standing in my own light. This one is one of my favorites. It is the Ganlin Royal Yellow. And it really reminds me of the, what is the name? Phalaenopsis Border Sarah Gold. And the flowers are absolutely gorgeous. And it is a sequential bloomer. I had a few buds, but they blasted. And so far it's looking okay. It is growing, and this one is in semi-hydro, and it absolutely loves its pot, because I'm not sure if I can show you, but you see the root tips, so it is actively growing. And yeah, it just loves the sun. And over here, also one of my favorites, my Phalaenopsis Surf Song. I absolutely love the color. This variety, you can buy it in supermarket or hardware shops. If you look for Phalaenopsis Surf Song, you can find it also online. So it's quite cheap. Standard hybrid, but I absolutely love the coloring. And what I also love is that the backside is a bit orange yellowish, but yeah, absolutely gorgeous. And that one is also in semi-hydro. I'm planning on switching it to, or is it, I said semi-hydro, it's in semi-water culture. And I'm planning on switching it to semi-hydro or maybe lava, because semi-water culture, it's a bit too much work for me, and I think semi-hydro will be a better option. Then over here, it's kind of poor looking, with all spent flowers and dried off spikes. But this was a Phalaenopsis soft cloud. It is a mini Phalaenopsis, and it produced quite a lot of spikes. And this one has 3 terminal spikes. So I read online it is a cake machine, so I'm dying to see some cakeys appearing. And yeah, I'm very pleased with it. It's quite pretty. It's, well, the name says soft cloud, and when it's in full flower, it has all little tiny flowers and just a spray of flowers. It's absolutely gorgeous. And over here, still in flower, also a no ID Phalaenopsis with soft pink flowers and a kind of orange throat. I think it's absolutely lovely. And I also self-pollinated it, and it looks very good. And this one is also in bark because I don't want to disturb it. So I think after I collected the seed pods, I will transfer it to either semi-hydro or lava. And over here is my purple martin. It's ready to flower. And it's such an easy Phalaenopsis. It just flowers about half the time of the year. And I absolutely love it. It's very cute. Over here in the back, right here, is also a no ID Phalaenopsis. And the bud is opening. And I know it is a sequential bloomer. And the flowers are quite small, but they're absolutely lovely. There are a bit red with yellow, orange, tiny flowers, and I just love it. Over here, this is an Oncidium, and I neglected it basically. And as you can see, it is in semi-hydro. This is a west, northwestern window, I think. So I just put it on the windowsill, and I thought, you know, it's never going to have enough light to do anything. But suddenly I saw a flower spike, and voila, there are some flowers. They are actually looking good. So I might keep it. And we're now in one of my bedrooms, and what I'm using for moving are those crates. They are from a supermarket, and they are really, really sturdy, so they will come in quite handy for the move. But now I unpacked my other fenders from the closet, and they are looking good. Over here in my windowsill, it's quite difficult to see, but in the pink container, there's a Lelia purpurata, and it has a beautiful sheet white right there. And I do see some really small buds inside. And next to it, over there, is my Angraecum Tomorrow Star. And over here is a very lovely Oncidium. So they are catching the last rays of sun. And these are my other Oncidiums. They are not catching a lot of light over here, but I think it's the most I can give them right now, but they are looking okay. I do see some new roots growing, like for example on this Brassia. And yeah, for the time being it's okay. And here are some Cattleyas. The yellow flowers are from a Dendrobium phalaenopsis. It will be okay. And here in my orchid shelf I have some phalaenopsis, a few Cattleya seedlings, my Dendrobium osmosmum, which is not doing anything, my Dendrobium agrigatum, that looks good. I do have a Epicattleya Fucano trick crossed with a Lelia Cattleya. It's not looking very good, but yeah, I don't really mind. Well, I'll just see what it does. And over here some Phalaenopsis. And here's my Dendrobium Phalaenopsis. And the flowers are not really looking good, but they grew into the light, so they are a bit burnt. But yeah, it will be okay. What not will be okay are my twinkles. I absolutely neglected them, and I have one spike over here, and I have a spike, yeah, over there. You can see it right here. But I'm not sure what to do with them. I think I might toss them. They never done well for me in semi-hydro. And yeah, they're just a hassle. So yeah. But this is my twinkle I got from Inse. And it is still in bark. And it's looking okay. I do have some browning tips, but I think that is just usual with twinkles. And I definitely am keeping this twinkle. And then some phalaenopsis in semi-water culture. And I'm waiting for higher temperatures so I can switch them to semi-hydro. And over here, some more phalaenopsis. I absolutely love these flowers. They are gorgeous. And more phalaenopsis in full water culture. And this is a gorgeous no ID in semi-hydro. And let me get you in closer. I don't know if you can see it, but it is putting out a root on the bottom and two new roots on top. And you can see it's extremely dusty because of the construction work I had to do. I have to clean that orchid. And that is another phalaenopsis. It is my... I always forget the name. It is a Princess Kaiulani. And yeah, she's doing really, really great. Over here is my Engragum sesquipedale. And it's still tiny. It is under grow lights. And it is in semi-hydro. And I just saw another root peeking. And so it's doing absolutely gorgeous. And then here two more phalaenopsis in the back in semi-hydro. And over here, this is my huge phalaenopsis Leodoro. I absolutely love this. And it is in full water culture. And I accidentally cracked this leaf, but yeah, so sad. So I hope it will create another leaf. I don't see any signs yet, but yeah, she will be okay. And over here, some more Phalaenopsis in water culture. This is my Brassavola nodosa in semi-hydro. And over here is my Digbiana. No, I'm not saying that right. Brassavola Digbiana. And it is also in semi-hydro. And it is putting out a new growth. Yay. I really have to flush this container. Okay, so we're now in my master bedroom. And as you can see, it is, well, packed. I use those crates to place my orchids. And it was easy for me to just pick up a crate and put it in my closet. And yeah, okay. So I'm not sure if I will unpack all my orchids, because within 1.5 months I will be moving. And those crates are really, really easy for transport. And every orchid inside of one crate is placed in that way that they don't fall over, and it just fits perfectly. So let's get you in closer. Okay, over here in flower is my Dendrobium Phalaenopsis. It is no ID, but I absolutely love those big magenta flowers. And it is in semi-hydro, and it's doing awesome. And here are some other cattleyas, and you can see here Phalaenopsis equistis here in the front. And I am excited because I just saw a new growth on my Francis Fox. And yeah, here is a Cattleya, it is the Forbesii, it is in lava, and I really want to transfer it to semi-hydro, but I'm waiting for new roots. But as you can see, there is a new growth, so roots will show up quite quick. And another one in lava is my Cattleya Ginmanii, and it's doing okay. But I prefer semi-hydro for my cattleyas. So here are more cattleyas and one Oncidium right here in the back. So here are more cattleyas. These are my seedlings. They are looking quite alright. They're close to the light. And yeah. They're doing okay. So I think I will just keep them here. And like I said, they're easy like this to transport. And I just take the whole crate, put it in the shower, and I just pour my fertilized water over them. And after that, I run a fan. And then I just place them back here under the lights. So for the time being, it just works great. And over here, I do have some fig cuttings, but they don't look really good. Here are some more cattleyas. And over here, I do have a few Phalaenopsis in lava, and let me show you one. Okay, just look at that. Those roots. You see that? Absolutely gorgeous. And even more. And that is my Phalaenopsis Rudimaniana. And I do think lava is just the perfect way to grow your Phalaenopsis. It means more watering, especially in summer. But you can control every feeding. So yeah, that's a huge benefit. Here is my Phalaenopsis gigantea. I'm not sure if you can see the little root peeking out. And it has only, you see the green? Oh, I'm sorry, it's not in focus. But over here, there's only one root inside of that container. So I'm very pleased to see a new root peeking out. And here's my other Phalaenopsis species. I'm not sure about the name because there is a tag inside the container, but the name faded, and I think it is Hieroglyphica. I'm not sure how to pronounce it, but yeah, it's looking gorgeous. And here in the crates are just more Cattleyas and Brassifolia, and yeah, they're looking good. And on top of this desk, I do have my Oncidium Sherry Baby. It is in full flower. Let me get you in closer. And the scent is really to die for. So these are the flowers. They look a bit more brown, a bit more orange than I'm used to. I'm not sure why. It could be a variety, but I don't know. But yeah, it is looking absolutely gorgeous. It is in semi-hydro, and I have one new growth right here. It's getting big. I have a new growth right there, and I do have one right here. So yeah, it's doing really, really great. And right here I have a Phalaenopsis. It's a no ID. I'm not a huge fan of the color combination, but what I do like is the huge fell. And it has a keiki here in the back. So I really like the shape of the Phalaenopsis. And yeah, I'm keeping this orchid because I think it can create a huge flower display. And I will be very pleased to see that. And last but not least is my other Phalaenopsis surf song. You can see the colors are a bit different, a bit more washed out, a bit paler. I think it's because of the light it's getting. But it was placed here for aesthetic reasons. We'll be moving it to a more brighter area. This one is in semi-hydro. You can see it is huge. It never lost a leaf. And it's my mini Vanda, I call it. So, alright guys, that was my little update. I will be less busy the couple of 2 months from now on. And I will make sure I'll post more videos. And I will keep you guys updated. Okay, thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye.